I love Star Trek, which is why I hate bad Star Trek. And you know, there are several kinds of bad Star Trek. There's a Star Trek that's just goofy, there's a Star Trek that has a good idea and screws it, and then there's the other kind of bad Star Trek, the Gene Roddenberry kind, the ham-fisted social commentary kind. And that's what kind we have today!
Social commentary!
So strap in and get ready for POSTOS, the Omega Glory. We begin with Kirk and the crew of the Enterprise on their way to the planet Omega-4.
Long-range sensor scan, Mr. Sulu. It's the USS Exeter, sir. She was patrolling in this area 6 months ago. Magnification factor 3, Mr. Sulu.
Stock footage from a previous episode.
Have Mr. Spock, Dr. McCoy, and Lieutenant Galway report to the transporter room to abort and investigate.
Do we need to do the Ensign Ricky joke again?
I put Tim in front to absorb the first hail of bullets.
Let's just say don't get too attached to Lieutenant Galway. So, Kirk, Spock, McCoy, and he's not quite dead yet, Jim, arrive on board the Exeter.
Just the uniforms, man.
As if they were in them when...
Exactly.
And Kirk does an all-call to try to get a hold of everyone.
To the USS Enterprise, is there anyone on board? If there is, if you can hear me, please respond by intercom to the engineering section. Is there anyone on board?
Bueller? Bueller? Bueller?
Jim, the analysis of this so far is potassium 35%, carbon 18%. Phosphorus 1.0, calcium 1.5. Jim, the crew didn't leave. They're still here.
What do you mean?
These white crystals are what's left of the human body when you take the water away, which makes up 96% of our bodies.
All we are is dust in the wind, dude.
Without water, we're all just 3 or 4 pounds of chemicals.
Dust? Wind? Dude.
Not sure what's happening? Spock plays the recording tape.
If you've come aboard this ship, you're dead men. You have one chance. Get down there. Get down there fast. Captain Tracy is...
Use me as I spelt.
So it's time to beam down. Fast!
Remember, kids, don't rush through the transport.
They arrive on the planet just in time for Kirk to hear his favorite sound of all, a woman struggling. And so they go and see and then stop an execution.
Put the axe away, Li Yang.
That's wrong, Tracy.
I knew someone would come looking for us. I'm just sorry it had to be you, Jim. Lock up the savages.
They carry fireboxes.
This is my boomstick!
So those two savage Yangs are arrested. And meanwhile, we find out that the comms, the peaceful Asians, somehow know about phasers.
You were left alone down here. What happened?
My landing party transported back to the ship. I stayed down here to arrange for the planet survey with the village elders. The next thing I knew, the ship was calling me. The landing party had taken an unknown disease back.
You don't mean boogie fever?
But I stayed alive because I stayed down here. There's some natural immunization that protects everyone on the planet's surface.
Lucky we found that log report. If we'd gone back to the Enterprise...
You'd be dying by now. You'll stay alive only as long as you stay here.
A wounded Galloway. Shocking.
We were approximately 100 meters from the village when five of the savages ambushed us. We managed to escape without firing.
Spock, do you see any hope that these Yangs can be reasoned with? A truce, a parley?
No, Captain.
Down to the depths, whatever mutton they thought of parley!
Captain Tracy is being quite factual in several statements. One, the Yangs are totally contemptuous of death. They seem incredibly vicious. Two, he is also being factual in that the Yangs are massing for an attack. There are signs of thousands of them in the foothills beyond.
Not that we'll ever see more than about five or six ever.
However, he was less than truthful in one very important matter.
Laser power packs.
Has Captain Tracy been interfering with the culture?
Found among the remains of several hundred Yang bodies.
Adoy!
People, the regulations are quite harsh, but they are also quite clear, Captain. If you do not act, you will be considered equally guilty.
But while they're making their plans... BETRAYAL!
I'll be sending the next message, Jim.
Galloway, we barely knew you. Really, we didn't even know your first name. Oh, Galloway, you almost made it to the Act 2 break. So Captain Tracy has Kirk, Spock, McCoy arrested and tries to call the Enterprise. But Kirk bravely steps in and... That.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant. Your captain's feverish, quite delirious.
I understand, sir.
Oh, wait. Kirk's not unconscious. He's gonna trip the garden.
That's enough of that, Captain.
That.
Whoa!
Captain Tracy tries to get Kirk on his side by explaining that he has found a modern-day Fountain of Youth.
Wu is 462 years old.
Are you grasping all it means? This immunizing agent here, once we've found it, is a fountain of youth. Virtual immortality.
Well, according to some sources, immortality isn't all it's cracked up to be.
Want to live forever. Want to live forever.
Oh, Kirk's gonna break out of his bounds and... That.
Well, if logic won't work, perhaps this will. Put him in there.
Oh boy, Kirk's locked up. What's gonna happen now? Oh, that. Oh, Kirk's getting tired, and so he nobly uses a woman as a human shield. Go, Kirk.
Keep trying, Captain. The behavior is highly illogical.
Meanwhile, back in the lab... McCoy, you dog. Haven't you possibly impregnated enough alien women? Spock tried to twist his bars out of his cell.
Captain Tracy mentioned there was once a considerable civilization here. The only reasonable explanation would be a war. A nuclear devastation or a bacteriological holocaust.
Keep working out the window if we're ever going to regain our freedom.
Freedom?
What will you do without freedom?
That is a worship word. Yang worship. You will not speak it.
Kirk and the Yang leader, figuring that two lunkheads are better than one, try to work together to free themselves. Alright, now Kirk and the Yang leader can team up and then... Oh. That.
How long? 7 hours and 8 minutes, Captain.
I had to fend off Dr. McCoy trying to put your hand in warm water several times. But luckily, the Yang's escape has opened up a convenient plot hole through which falls...
Spock. Keith. I'll have you out in a minute.
Meanwhile, back at the lab, Dr. McCoy has discovered that the crew can leave anytime they want because the immunity has built up.
These immunizing agents take time, and that's the real tragedy. Had the extra landing party stayed here just a few hours longer, they never would have died.
Tracy's of the opinion that these immunizing agents can become a fountain of youth. There are people here over 1,000 years old, Bones.
It's poppycock. I can do more for you if you just eat right and exercise regularly.